Greetings. The Torah and Bible contain the message of the prophets. If you want to honor God, you should respect the message his prophets brought. We have seen that Prophet Moses brought the usage of the word Echad instead of using the word Yahid. What other prophets have brought revelation from God, which gives hints or clues of something more than God is one alone? Before getting into that, I must lay out two foundations for you to remember and be aware of. Foundation number one, when Jesus was resurrected, he taught the disciples all that concerned him in the Old Testament. John 5:39. You diligently study the scriptures because you think that by them you possess eternal life. These are the scriptures that testify about me. Now in this verse, Jesus was actually telling the Jewish leaders this before he was even crucified, killed, and resurrected. Luke 24:25. Then he said unto them, O fools and slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have spoken. Ought not Christ to have suffered these things and to enter into his glory? And beginning at Moses and all the prophets, he expounded unto them in all the scriptures the things concerning himself. Acts 17:3, explaining and proving that the Christ had to suffer and rise from the dead. This Jesus, I am proclaiming to you, is the Christ, he said. Foundation number two, after Jesus was resurrected and ascended to God, he sent the Comforter, whose stated purpose was to lead the disciples into all truth. John 14:25, these things have I spoken unto you, being yet present with you. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things, and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you. Please pay attention, O Mohammedans. This is Jesus saying the Holy Spirit will remind the disciples what Jesus taught them. Remember foundation number one. What did Jesus teach them? And beginning at Moses and all the prophets, he expounded unto them in all the scriptures the things concerning himself. Jesus taught them all the prophecies about himself. The Comforter, the Holy Spirit, reminded them of all the prophecies about Jesus. The New Testament recorded all the message of the Injil about Jesus. So those are the two foundations you must understand, O Mohammedan. Jesus taught them about every scripture that applied to himself, and the Holy Spirit reminded them of every scripture that applied to him. Christians, shout glory to God. Can you see how faithful God was to both teach and then remind the disciples? And if you follow Islam, notice, my friend, and pay attention to how God has faithfully supported his message. So let's move on with that understanding of the foundation of the reliability of the text of the Word of God. Prophet David is claimed to be respected by Islam. And I don't know if Islam defines prophet as the Jews and Christians do, but Jews and Christians believe prophets brought the words God wanted them to say and teach. So how many of you know Prophet David revealed that God had a son? Well, let's look at what Prophet David revealed in Psalms 2. Perhaps you have been taught that this is David speaking about himself. Perhaps you have been taught Psalm 2 is all about David himself. Well, let us look in context at what it says. Psalm 2, verse 1. Why do the heathen rage and the people imagine a vain thing? Notice in Acts 4:25, the apostles have referred to this scripture in Psalm 2. You spoke by the Holy Spirit through the mouth of your servant, our father David. Why do the nations rage and the peoples plot in vain? Psalm 2:2, continuing. The kings of the earth set themselves, and the rulers take counsel together against the Lord and against his anointed, saying, notice again in Acts 4:26, the kings of the earth take their stand, and the rulers gather together against the Lord and against his anointed one. Some translators state, against the Lord and against his Messiah, because anointed one is Messiah. Well, let us look at what the disciples that had been taught by Jesus, said about how to apply this verse, and who this verse pertained to, and how to truly understand it. Acts 4:27, indeed, Herod and Pontius Pilate met together with the Gentiles and the people of Israel in this city to conspire against your holy servant Jesus, whom you anointed. The kings of the earth take their stand, and the rulers gather together. Here we see Herod, Pontius Pilate, and the people of Israel even, conspiring, gathering together, against the Lord and against his anointed one, against his holy servant, Jesus. Acts 4:28, they did what your power and will had decided beforehand should happen. Now, whose power and will are the disciples talking about? God's. The disciples are confirming that everything which happened to Jesus was by the power and will of God. So we know, looking at these two verses and how the disciples interpreted them, that Psalms 2 is talking about Jesus, God's Messiah. Dear brother, can you see that reading the context is important? Can you see that by reading the context, we know that Prophet David was talking about Jesus? Verse 3, let us break their bands asunder and cast away their cords from us. He that sitteth in the heavens shall laugh. The Lord shall have them in derision. Then shall he speak unto them in his wrath and vex them in his sore displeasure. Yet have I set my king upon my holy hill of Zion. Psalm 2:7. I will declare the decree the Lord hath said unto me. Notice, this is Prophet David saying that he is about to declare the decree, a message that the Lord has given him. It doesn't mean the message is about him. It means he, David the prophet, is going to declare the decree that God has told him to say. Thou art my son, this day have I begotten thee. And who was Prophet David talking about earlier? The Anointed One, the Messiah, Jesus. Please allow that to sink in, O Mohammedan. We know from the context that Prophet David was talking about Jesus when he declared the decree from God. You are my son, this day have I begotten thee. So respecting Prophet David and his message, we see that God revealed his son. Remember, understanding the Trinity means accepting the message of the prophets and understanding it the way the Comforter explained it to the disciples. This is just one more piece of evidence that God has a son, and the prophets revealed it. And one more piece of evidence that God is a Trinity of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, because the prophets have revealed it. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.